Alright guys, it is Sunday evening at the moment when I'm recording this. I have just had a shower, it's been boiling all day, now it's really cool and I feel great. So I'm going to be doing a few videos now, like I always do, and I'm going to be trying to follow the comments as much as I can, because it seems that the majority of the comments are screaming for a jail and for some kind of defence. And the thing is, there wouldn't have been no jail or any form of defence until the population is significantly higher than it is now. So what I'm going to be doing is allocating an area, which is going to be this area here, and I'm going to be having a huge housing boom. And I don't want to fast forward through building any of the houses and stuff like that, so I want to make loads of different houses, and I want to make them all different. That's going to be quite important, because I don't want to bore you guys. Other things I'd like to say is, someone wanted me to build a lumber mill. I'm actually going to be doing that in this episode, and I'll be doing the houses in later episodes. And here's like just a kind of general request. If you're going to suggest something, that's absolutely fine. But could you do it in a kind of less demanding way? Because every now and then I get comments like, oh, I love the series, how about you try this when they get this, or something like that. And that is great, that makes me feel really good, and I just, you know, if it's good, I do it. And then I just get a huge amount of comments which are just like, you should have one of these, there should be one of these, why is there not one of these? And it's like, okay. It, you know, it really gets on my fucking nerves. So, anyway, that's my little moan over. Let's start building this lumber mill. I'm going to be putting the lumber mill kind of here-ish, so I need to clear away this land. And, I'm putting it here because it's kind of around all the rest of the, what do you call it, kind of industrial sort of stuff, like the masons and things like that. But first I need to get rid of all these trees, which is a bit counterproductive because I'm building a lumber mill and getting rid of trees, but I suppose that's more realistic in a way. I have so much energy! This is great. I've been playing lots of Battlefield Beta and it's freaking awesome! I freaking love it. If I had a capture card, I'd upload some footage, but I guess this is a Minecraft channel, so that wouldn't really matter anyway. So I'm going to type in full-size brush cylinder air 6. And I'm going to get rid of some of this land over here. So, just flattening all this out. That's quite a lot of flattening. Let's even this all out a little bit. I could actually lower this pathway and lower this bit of land here as well. Yeah, I'll do it. I'll sort this all out later and make it look a bit cleaner. What the hell's happening? Cool. Go away. Thank you. Let's get rid of that, get rid of that, get rid of that. There we go. So I've got a lot more land where I can begin working from. Let's get rid of that and flatten out this bit here like that. Okay, so I don't need to make any of this pretty yet. That'll do for now. That won't. There we go. What I could actually do is full slash replace near, say 50, no, 30, 40, dirt, grass. There you go. And that should make everything look a bit nicer. That's actually, I've just realised that that's probably gone underground as well. It might have cocked up a few, it was fine, it'll wear off. It'll be okay. Right, so let's start building. I'm going to start off with putting some wood piles, and I'm not really sure how I'm going to do these wood piles. Maybe I'll... Oh, I know. Okay, so I'm going to start off by actually building the mill itself, and I'm going to be basing this heavily on the World of Warcraft mill, so if you've seen that, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Damn it. God damn it. There we go. There is a moth in my face. Fuck off. Okay. So there's going to be pillars, and these are obviously going to be made out of wood, and we're going to have a saw going down the middle. So, if say the saw is going down this block here, let's have like that, nope, like that, there we go. And I want this kind of in the middle of an area, because I'm going to be putting a lot of lumber around this area. I want it quite high, and we want the roof to be made out of something quite substantial. I'm not entirely sure, this is quite wide. I want something nice and flat. I'm just going to be making it same style as this, except with half blocks, so more like this warehouse here. What I could do is connect up this warehouse, but this warehouse is more of a, yeah, it's more of a shop now than a warehouse, so that's okay. That's alright. So let's take my wooden slabs. Now, how high is this? I want it a bit higher than this building, so this is 2 and then a block, so I'm going to go 3 and then a block. So this is going to be quite a big building, but it's alright. That's okay. And obviously this amount of lumber means that we're going to be able to build a lot more, or rather our villagers are going to be able to build a lot more, which will be good. Let's scroll along like this. One block overhang, and come along like this. There we go. There we go. And we'll come across like that. Now, we want some kind of cool beam thing going on here, but I'll sort that out in just a second. After I put up these half blocks and then these full blocks. And then I have a little choke. There we go. Fail. There we go. And I will sort that out in just a tick when I've done this. My god, I have a lot of energy tonight. This makes such a change. I've been knackered. But today I've done nothing but play Battlefield 3 and a bit of StarCraft. That's, I think that's it. oh. What did I do? Nope, nope. There we go. Okay, so let's put a few beams across. Actually, I can have quite a substantial little beam set up here. Let's think about this. Thinking pillars. I don't know, because this is quite a big building, so I think it would have some pillars, but I don't know where to put them because I made it stupid sized. God damn it. God damn it. Damn it. Damn it. God. Dirt. And there we go. Okay, let's move this out a little bit again. My phone's making my speakers make a noise, and I don't know where my phone is, and it's really bugging me. Right, where are you? There you are. What are you doing over there? How is the phone all the way over there making my speakers make noise? That's fucking ridiculous. Right. And, okay, so now we can have a centre pillar here, and that can go up the same way. I don't really like the way that the pillars are going across. I think I might lower it a bit and do this kind of shebang, and then I just said shebang, didn't I? I should probably go kill myself now. Never mind. Right, and then let's have maybe a pillar going up through the middle. Maybe a kind of diagonal kind of thing going on. Nope. About here and here. That looks pretty strange. Right, what if I... Oh, I know. I know. Gonna go back on everything I just did. It all will become clear. There we go. Now I can do this kind of thing. Ah, that's nice. There we go. Now I've got a nice kind of even curve going up into the top. That. There we go. That looks... That's a lot nicer shape. Okay, and I'm also gonna have bits going up like this, so it just makes the building look a lot more compact. This is probably the biggest lumber construction we've got going on so far, and there will be a bigger one when I get round to, how's that, should I have that sticking at the end, maybe, I don't know, that sticking at the end, nope, yeah, the next construction is going to be bigger than this. Is actually going to be the Great Hall, and I'll explain a little bit about that as we get there. I'm just going to make this roof a little bit more non-weird. There we go. So the inside looks like the roof goes up by half block, by steps, but the outside is flat. That's quite nice. Quite a nice little effect we've got going on there. Although it probably looked better if I just made the whole roof go up by the amount that I did. Oh, I don't know. Don't even want to undo it. Now, screw it, I'll leave it like this, I might change it later. Now, I actually have quite a good thing to make the saw blade out of, but I want to implant it in something, so I'm going to be using this. Oh, I know, I've just had an idea. Actually, no, that might look a bit weird. Now, let's try it anyway. So, if we've got the saw blade kind of coming along like this. Alright, let's implant it into the floor then. And this would be the kind of trough where you put the wood in, if that makes any sense at all. And then the saw blade will absolutely fail. Damn it! I did not take that into consideration. Oh, flip, I should have made this an even number long. Oh wait, I did make this an even number long. What am I going on about? Right, well that means we can leave that there. And then just put these like these. These like these. And that goes along like that. And then the saw blade. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's so shit. What is even going on here? There, that actually does kind of look like a saw blade. I'm actually kind of surprised at how well that came out. Awesome. Cool, now I want the whole floor to be made out of, I don't know, wood, I guess. No, but so if we're going to be putting wood in, we don't want it to look like wood, because that'll look a bit strange. Let's have cobblestone then. And we'll put the cobblestone all around here. Like this. There we go, and one bit of grass there. Alright, let's see how this looks then. I think this is looking quite nice. We need some kind of mechanism that makes it look like there is somewhere for the saw blade to put it in, and we actually need a block being cut in half, I think. That would look quite good. And now for the block, we're going to be using this wool, because it looks like it's on its side. How would you... Right, let's raise it up a block then. So if I use... like this, maybe. What about like this? Does that look kind of like rollers? So that's... Ooh, I'll tell you what, I could actually have it halfway through the blade already. So it looks like it's already been cut in half. Actually, that would look a lot cooler if it was a bit lower down. If the log comes along here, and it looks like it's already come halfway through the blade. And then we need something to make this look a bit better, because it looks a bit stupid. There we go, it looks like it's already been cut in half. It's a bit of an odd shape. Kind of want it to come out to here, didn't we? Yeah, I'm going to leave it like that. So now it looks like the log's been cut in half. I think that looks really cool, I'm really happy with that. Now I'm going to put some braces down like this. Just so it looks like kind of like a guiding rail, so like you put it in the end and then roll it along. And let's build this out a little bit more. There we go. Stop flying, annoying thing. Right, so there's our log going in, it's getting chopped in half, that's pretty cool. And then obviously the produce would be some, we've got some half blocks, we've got some crates, let's pile up some crates over here. Almost as if it makes up the wall, that would look quite cool. So it's kind of spilling out over here, like this. I need to stop pressing W tap to fly, there we go. Right, so there's some crates there. Gonna be some crates here, just kind of randomly spread around, and then some bigger crates, and some bigger crates over this side, and this is going to be kind of our finished produce side. Lots of lumber over here, and on this side is where we're going to be leaning up our logs to get cut. So we're going to take our dark wood, just because it's different to this wood and I don't want it to look the same. And then I'm going to kind of build some kind of grooves in here so it looks like it's supposed to hold them up, and I'll make that look a little bit more convincing by sticking some fence gates. How would that look? Oh, it needs to be placed on something. What would be nice and easy to make it look like it's being attached? Trapdoor going around it? No, we'll see. So these are like logs being stacked up. different lengths a little bit. Nice and random looking. And then here are some logs being... No, we need to use the other texture, don't we? We need to use this one. It does look really weird when... Looks like... also, for people who are saying, why don't you just change the log texture around? That doesn't work because there's two different types of texture on one piece of wood if you look at this piece here. In fact, if I put it up and I can look underneath it. Nope, one, two, three. Stop flying! Right, so see there's one which does the top and bottom, and then there's one more which does all the sides. So if I flip these around, then what we'd have is two sides here and here. And then the ends, which are these bits here, would be that side, and that side. So it would look like a four-sided piece of wood. It's kind of hard to explain, but basically it wouldn't work. So people who are saying, do that, I can't. Also, I've just realised that these woods are the wrong, what would you call it, angle. So I need to change these round so that they look normal, like this. Let's kind of give it a little pile effect. And so a little bit more on top. And make that look cut down by the rails. Yay! Oh, bugger. That won't do, will it? Got to have another log. Fail. There we go. So there's our pile of logs. These are our logs ready to get cut. This is our log being cut. Very cool. This is our end produce. We can have some more of these kind of stacked around, so that's kind of like lots of... these are kind of like pallets of wood. If you know what a pallet is, I don't know if you use a different word in America. Pallets of wood there, and then there's some normal wood. It's going to start raining again, and then we've got our flooring wood, which can go over here. These nice little neat stacks. There we have it. So there's our lumber mill there. It's added a nice little section to our town. Why did it not stop raining? Stop raining. Stop it. Thank you. Right, so let's get rid of all of this crap. And I can actually do that by using this because I've already got a key bound. There we go. And I'll get some water to put over here. Let's use some eyes. Oh, for God's sake, I've already done that once, haven't I? I've already made that mistake once. Water bucket, water bucket. Thank you. Water bucket. Water bucket. That was strange. Why did it only spread in one direction?